Hello everyone, welcome back to our Farming RPG tutorial series. So we have our player controller down, and our player can move around, sprint, walk, and stand still. All three animations working perfectly. And now we are going to do the camera movement, because as of now, our camera doesn't follow our player. Well, the easiest way to get our camera to work is to just attach it to our play object like this. But you see, the problem with doing this is that it just follows the player's perspective. And that this is not what we want. So let's undo that. So instead, we will be making the camera follow our player by script. So first, let's adjust our camera to get a good view. Okay, something like this. So we want our camera view to look something like this. So let's create a new script. Call it camera controller. Drag it in here. So we'll be making the camera follow our player by script. To do this, we first need our player position. We'll be doing this with the transform component on our player. So to retrieve this, we'll be using find object of type. So what this does is that it finds the game object with the player controller component, and after that we'll take its transform. That way, we are able to find the player position by script. So this is called at the start, but we want our camera to be constantly following our player. So we have to put it in the update function. Let's make a function to follow the player and put it in update. Now on to follow the player. So since this is a simple camera controller setup, we just want to make the camera follow our player. So we just have to set the camera's position to our player's position. But if we were to try this, the camera is exactly at the player's position, which is not what we want. We want our camera to just be at the player position, but it shouldn't follow its y-axis. So how do we alter that? What we can do is we can declare a Vector3 variable, call it target position. This is the position our camera should be in. Going to be a vector that takes in our player position's x coordinate, because we wanted to follow our player, it's x coordinate. But we're going to keep our own coordinates, so the camera will remain this high up. So transform.y and playPause.z. Position, sorry. Target position. So instead of setting it to the player's position, we set it to the new vec modified vector 3 position. And this, when we play, it's still not where we want to, because in our, because it's exactly, it's z, its position on the z-axis, it's exactly on top of the player. And that's not what we want. We want it to be slightly behind the player. So how do we do this? We have to modify the position here. So to do that, let's declare a new variable, call it offset z. In this offset, let's set it to I. Now if you were to try it, there, exactly as we want. We can always adjust the offset here. Just set it to whatever level you're comfortable with. Maybe I'll set it to 6. But if you notice something, it's that the player is a bit jittery now, because it's following the player exactly at every frame. It's just, so it's not as smooth. So let's add some smoothing to this. So instead of just setting it to its target position, we'll be using something called vector3.lerp. So it interpolates between two points. So let's start with our point position, transform the position. So that's where the camera currently is, and then it should move towards the target position instead of just teleporting there. And the rate in which it moves can be controlled by smoothing times time dot delta time. So there's some leeway before the camera moves over. We can increase the rate in which it moves. There. So our camera now looks pretty smooth. So let's change this. Yep, it's exactly as we want. So that's it for this tutorial. Hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for our next part.